Recently, dentists in other parts of the country have been accused of putting patients at risk with improperly cleaned equipment. So, what can ensure that yours isn't a dirty dentist?
As a patient, you trust the dentist, and we love you for it because you trust us. Your trust is such a big responsibility for us that it makes us do much better than we thought we could. You also trust the dentist that he or she has his instruments which are in your mouth are clean. And that trust, if broken, can spread hepatitis B, hepatitis C, HIV. It could cause many other diseases. As a patient, you must think that there must be some kind of law which states that every dentist has to have a certain minimum. Yes, there are laws, but enforcement is another ballgame. Here in India, we as a dentist, if you are moral and ethical, you will sterilize your instruments, you will keep it clean, but there are no checks. There is nobody coming into my office to check. They don't know what I do. Nobody sees if my autoclave is working. Nobody comes, checks my drawers if they have been fumigated. Nobody checks if my countertops are clean. So this is what is taken advantage of in many clinics and many dental offices, maybe because of inadequate. Maybe because of inadequate time or just pure laziness. This cannot happen. Every patient assumes it is clean. I go to a restaurant and I assume that the chef doesn't spit in my food and the cutlery is clean. That is what I assume. I don't know. So as an owner of a restaurant, you should be diligent enough, and that's the reason you go to restaurants which you trust, and you go to a restaurant which looks clean, smells clean. You see the cutlery in front of you. You see if it's clean. You see the vessel it comes in. So there are things in which how you know a restaurant is clean. So how do you know a dentist is clean? When you go to a reception, you will know. You will know if you've come to a showroom or a Mercedes showroom. You will know. If you're in the wrong place, walk out. See what the dental assistants are wearing. Are they walking around with gloves? Are they touching other things with their gloves? See if there are barriers put on chairs, on light handles, on things the dentist touches very often. If there are no barriers, walk away. Instruments have to be in sterilized pouches with indicators on them. These indicators turn a different color when they are sterilized, and they are sterilized in an autoclave. An autoclave should have indicators which should be checked every month for its effectiveness. If you don't see barriers, if you don't see instruments packed in bags which open in front of you, I would say just walk away. One more thing, don't get treated by assistants. Only a dentist knows, only a specialist knows, only a trained dentist knows what sterilization and sterilization and asepsis is. If you still feel uncomfortable, ask a few questions. Call them up before coming. Ask them, how do you sterilize? How often do you sterilize? Just to give you an example, here we take at least 5 minutes between each patient. We start disinfecting, we start spraying, we disinfect the chair, the spittoon, the tumblers are changed, most of them are disposable, the suction units are drained, the countertops are cleaned, the drawers we touch are also disinfected. Anything which is out of the drawer gets cleaned before being put back in the drawer. So it takes at least 3 to 5 minutes between patients. If you have two assistants, it probably takes less. If you are in the waiting room, see how much time it takes between two patients. You'll kind of have an idea how much time they take to clean the dental chair. You don't see barriers or you don't see bags, instrument bags. If you don't feel the floor is clean or the environment is clean enough, I would suggest walk away, because otherwise you will get your treatment done and you'll always have something in the back of your mind that you have. You'll have a feeling of a dirty spoon in your mouth, and worst off, you get some kind of fever, you will definitely blame the dentist. So just don't get the treatment done from there. Do your research, find another place.